We shall discuss Johnson counter here. Johnson counter can also be called as complemented switch tail or ordinary switch tail counter. Johnson counter is that very counter whose asynchronous implementation is not possible. So, in case of Johnson counter, if there are n bit Johnson counter, if we require n number of flip-flops for the construction of the Johnson counter, then the counter will have 2 into n number of states. Now let us discuss what is the counting sequence of Johnson counter. So here the value of n is equal to 4 because we are dealing with 4 bit Johnson counter. So that's why we are having 4 bits for each and every counting state. So that's why it will be having 2 into 4, that is 8 number of states in the Johnson counter. So Johnson counter can also be called as switch tail counter because here this last bit, that is the switch tail, that is the last bit of this counting state will be complemented. So it will be complemented. So it will be coming to this place and this C place will be shifted towards the right. So that is the way to do it. That means the last bit will be complemented and that bit will be shifted to the MSB place. That is the most significant bit place and those three bits will be shifted towards the right for one bit position. So again this bit will be complemented, so it will be coming down here and these three bits will be going here. In this way the Johnson counter will work. And you can find that if you complement this one, then this bit will be coming at this place and this three bit place will be shifted towards the right for one bit place. So ultimately you are going to get 0, 0, 0, 0, that is the initial state of the counting sequence, and that is the purpose of our Johnson counter. So now let us consider the timing diagram of this Johnson counter. Here is the timing diagram for us. So here we are drawing the clock pulse at the top. We know that for 4 bit Johnson counter we shall be having 8 number of states, so the clock pulse should have 8 number of peaks. And while drawing this clock pulse on your exam copy, please make them equidistant. And in this way, you should draw it. Here we have considered that is the falling edge triggered flip-flop. So edge triggered means this triangle and this bubble is indicating it is falling edge triggered. So at the falling edge, that means from high to low transition of the clock pulse, we have drawn these dotted lines here. We have drawn the dotted lines throughout. Now we shall be writing say 0, 0, 0, 0. Then these bits will be complemented, it will be going there and these three bits will be shifted towards the right as we had discussed earlier. So that's why the bits will be plotted in this way. So this is my 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. In this way, the bits will be written just after, not before, just after the dotted lines. Then we shall draw these respective lines there. And that will be denoting the signal pulse. For 0, we will be drawing the lower line. For 1, we shall be drawing the upper line. Whenever there will be a transition from low to high or from high to low, always the transition will be taken place across this, against this particular falling edge of the clock pulse. So they will be having the transitions on the dotted vertical lines, and that is mandatory. So while drawing such timing diagrams, you should remain very cautious. And accordingly, the drawing has to be made. Now we shall go for the circuit design. So here is the respective circuit for us. You can find that it is nothing but a counter constructed with the D flip-flop, because here we are supposed to have the shifting towards the right. So that's why Q3 has been connected to D2, Q2 has been connected to D1, Q1 has been connected to D0, so that the bits can go for right shift whenever the clock pulse has got applied. And this clock pulse is connected to all flip-flops because I told you earlier the asynchronous version of Johnson counter is not possible. You may ask me why the asynchronous version of Johnson counter is not possible. Then the answer will be like this. Consider any kind of transition. Just consider from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0 anywhere. You can find that there is no other falling edge at that particular instant of time. I'm going to show you. Let us suppose that is a transition from 0 to 1. You can find that there is no other transitions from other outputs of the flip-flop. Only the clock pulse, only the main CP is having the falling edge. So that's why each and every transition in the outputs are taking place across the against the falling edge of the main CPU. So that's why this counter is synchronous, so all the flip-flops are connected to the common central CPU. Now here you can find that the LSB, that is the least significant bit, whatever you are going to get at Q0, its complement, that is Q0 bar, is going to D3, so that the switch tell logic can be applied. Fourth stage, switch tell ring counter. In this way, the Johnson counter can be constructed. Thanks for watching this video.